Scientists reckon that one is a huge comet, but has so far been unable to identify the other. The comet is set to fly close to Earth this week, but the mystery object isn't expected to make an appearance until February. The object, dubbed 2016 WF9, was detected by NASA's Asteroid Hunting and Comet Hunting NEOWISE project on November 27 last year. It is roughly 0.3 to 0.6 miles, 0.5 to 1 kilometers across, and is in an orbit that takes it on a scenic tour of our solar system. At its farthest distance from the Sun, it approaches Jupiter's orbit. Over the course of 4.9 Earth years, it travels inward, passing under the main asteroid belt in the orbit of Mars until it swings just inside Earth's own orbit. After that, it heads back toward the outer solar system. However, NASA scientists are not sure whether it is a comet or an asteroid. Deputy Principal Investigator James Gerbs Bauer at NASA said, 2016 WF9 could have cometary origins. This object illustrates that the boundary between asteroids and comets is a blurry one. Perhaps over time this object has lost the majority of the volatiles that linger on or just under its surface. NASA has been checking data sent from an explorer called WISE, the Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer. Stargazers may be able to spot the comet in the southeastern section of the sky shortly before dawn this week. It is moving farther south each day, and it will reach its closest point to the Sun, inside the orbit of Mercury, on Saturday, January 14, before heading back out to the outer reaches of the solar system for an orbit lasting thousands of years. While the comet may be visible, it is not considered to be a threat to the planet. On February 25, the other object, 2017 WF9, will approach Earth's orbit at a distance of nearly 32 million miles, 51 million kilometers, from our home planet. Meanwhile, the NASA/ESA Hubble Space Telescope, partly designed in Cambridge, has taken a picture of two galaxies crashing into each other, over a billion light-years away. Called LIGO 52270, the doomed duo approached one another too closely, gravity causing them to affect and tug at each other, and slowly, destructive